every seminar has a special topic. And thinking through all the years, I saw that in the 80s we had topics about the relationship between artist and the church, or artist and faith and all that stuff. And then in the 90s, we moved to topics like, how is the world around us? But because who are you as a Christian artist? You live in this world, but then what is this world all about? And then 10 years later, we moved to topics like working conditions and the real nasty stuff that you all will face when you go into a professional career as an artist. And then it doesn't matter you're a dancer, a musician, or a painter, or a filmer, you all face the same number of problems. And that came more or less to a conclusion last year. So I've been thinking and praying then, what is the topic for this year? And then I saw there is one thing left. And during this week, we will speak a little bit about it. That is your personal motivation. Because even if you were able to change all the things around you to have a perfect environment for your art, still people will fail. And if you study why people fail, you finally comes on two things. Maybe there's a problem with the quality of your gift, of your art. Maybe there is another problem that you should follow more education in your art, but we have covered that in past years. Or maybe there is something about motivation. And especially this year, we felt, let's talk about this last chapter, motivation. So we are here then together to learn from each other in a spirit of servanthood. And for the ones who are new, we are not here in an area of competition, but of collaboration, of understanding. And if you don't know, just ask, because we all started to learn by asking. So asking is a great gift. So the verse of today is saying this. It comes from Acts. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses to the ends of the earth. And another verse from Philippians, you find it as well in your program book. I can do everything through him who gives me the strength, or the word is power of or energy. And that is what I hope and pray, that you will find new energy for your life. So let us pray together. Dear God, we want to thank you. We can be here together. We ask your Holy Spirit to come and give us the energy and the inspiration to move on day by day in our gift to be a blessing for this world. Amen. So we have an artist to start up this afternoon, Jan-Willem van Delft. You all know him. And if you watch TV, you'll see him regularly in TV programs. Jan-Willem.
Well, it's good to be back. And because of the time, I have a very short introduction on our first and only song of today. This song would not have existed without the Christian Artist Seminar. So that's, I think, very special of CA that things will happen and get into life through the seminar. The lyrics of this song were written by none other than Peter Smith. And I think he's there already. Peter, are you there? Well, okay. And and the lyrics were so inspiring to me that the melody almost came naturally. The text may seem strange or odd to you at first, But this is my interpretation of the lyrics. Let CA be a place and moment in time where you will be inspired, comforted, filled with love and new strength, so that you can be a sunny day in someone's dark valley. And be blessed with that thought.
you. The next artist, he's from Scotland. Whoa. Philip Noble. And he has been us a good number of times. Always amazing, or with strings or balloons, and he has he wants to show you some great new inventions. So we are glad we have here somebody who will stay with us even after the Brexit. Philip, give him a big hand.
It's wonderful to be here again, and I want to share with you some things. I loved what Lean was saying about personal motivation. I think Walt Whitman once said that he wanted to be an itinerant gladness scatterer. Okay, and I love that idea of being someone who actually just wants to scatter wonder or gladness. So what I want to show you is a little video. I came up with this idea for a puppet. About January, that's one of the titles of the song you'll hear. Most people who work with soap bubbles have a machine to put fog inside the bubble so you can see it at a distance. But it's like a box like that with a tube in it. It doesn't look very attractive. So I came up with the idea of making a little dragon with a tail coming out. His name is Stevie. So you're going to see Stevie, and they're going to see him put some fog inside a bubble. You're going to see him make a bubble like a volcano, a cube bubble, and the final one, which is a trick from a man called Tom Noddy, a real expert in soap bubbles, which is called the tornado bubble. It's only about 3 minutes long, but Stevie the dragon, here he comes.
Happy birthday to you. Happy New Year. January train has caught me in latitude again. January train has brought me into longitude again. January train, January train has taught me how to focus again. January train has brought me around and around again. Ages come and go in procession, 216, so all mixed up in sons and daughters. Houses of the hens turn again, again, and there's still plenty time for January train. January train has shown me snowdrop beauty again. January rain has found me in river rhythm.
Next artist, young talent from Germany, Christine Fischer. She's new, so give her a warm hand, Christine. Show what you can.
name's Christine. I'm from Germany. In German, you pronounce my name Christine, and my short name is Stine. So when you see me, you can just call me Stine. That's nice. I'm a singer. I study jazz and popular music in Germany. And last year, I formed my very own band, which is pretty cool. I do my own songs in German. So I'm going to sing in German today as well. So I try to translate a little bit. I brought two songs. One is a ballad, one is a more up-tempo song. And the first one, it's called Mein Wort. I would translate it with My Promise. And it is about someone who's, yeah, like in a really deep, dark hole. And I want to say, take my hand, I'm gonna be with you, I stay with you. And we do this together, and we find a new way out of this mess. Okay.
Du sitzt da, Kraft und
Thank you. Sorry, I'm a little bit nervous. So, okay, the next song is called Nur Millimeter, which means like only millimeters. And it's basically about my sister. She lives like 500 kilometers far away from me, but she's like my best friend. We're deeply connected with each other. And it says that it doesn't matter how far we live away from each other, nothing is gonna break our connection because we're so deeply rooted. We have so much in common. And it's basically a love song to her. Yes, no millimeter. Deine Stadt schon wieder aufgewacht. So viel zu tun, nicht mal die Zeit, um rauszugehen. Meine Stadt schon wieder durchgemacht. Wolkentag, ich sehne mich nach Haus. Doch, wenn wir uns wiedersehen, uns ohne Worte verstehen, lauf auf dich zu und meine Arme weit aus. Deine Welt ist manchmal ein Stück zu klein. Einsamkeit, doch ich sag komm und laufe los. Meine Welt ist manchmal ein Stück zu klein. Ich sehne mich nach Haus. Doch wenn wir uns wiedersehen, uns ohne Worte verstehen, lauf auf dich zu und meine Arme weit auf. Ich und du. Jemals trennen, ich und du. Zusammen sind wir unaufhaltsam, mein sicherer Hafen immer zu. Meine Heimat, das bist du. Egal wie viele Kilometer zwischen uns liegen, in Wahrheit sind's nur Millimeter im Herz von mir zu dir.
Thank you. Wonderful. I wish I could sing that way. Something because I've not many spots this year in the seminar program, because I have a very special wife, as you all know. And lucky we are already married for a long time, 51 years. It's amazing. Yes, thank you. So, what she said is, you always speak in the evenings, I do it this year. So you will listen to her every evening, the coming days, and she moved me out of the way, so I'm in the morning. So, and that is a little bit how we are, because I'm a morning bird and she's a night bird, so we manage in a wonderful way. So where I wanted to speak with you about is motivation, and that is an energy curve. And I will put a little drawing on. For the ones who have followed my masterclass on cultural leadership, they know the figure. It comes from the social sciences. It is a curve like this. This is the zero line. It always goes like that. This plus, this is min. And everybody has a form of this cycle. And artists have it in a very strong way. Easy and fast, they go to plus. But when something happens, easy and fast, you go to minus. When you go up to plus 50, you go to minus 50. We as artists, creative people, we go easily to plus 100. Later on, we go to minus 100. This is how we are made. And some people have wrestled with that, and they think that when you cross the zero line in the total negative field, that it was an attack of the devil or so. It's not. It's just negative energy. You are demotivated. And now, it's interested, this is the positive side, motivation, and this is demotivation. Now, the interesting part, it starts here. When you are at the top of your positive energy, demotivation will start. And that can happen through little things I discovered. Let's say you made an incredible painting, and you have an exposition, and then, you've done a lot and hard work, and you think it's great. And then somebody comes to you after viewing your exposition and is saying, well, you know, it is interesting, but. Always wait for the but. Then you know, whoa. And little things can move you out of the plus very fast into a minus. Yeah. The most famous example in the Bible is the prophet Elijah. You know, the story on the Mount Carmel with those priests from pagan god worshippers. And God is an incredible miracle. Rain came and fire from heaven came. And then, so there's a great victory in the name of God. And then from the evil queen Jezebel comes a messenger to the prophet and is saying, as you have slaughtered my priests, you will be a dead man. You've signed your death warrant. The next moment, the prophet runs away like crazy, like mad, and is hiding in a bush in the desert. Plus 1,000 to minus 1,000. And now the amazing thing is, if God did rescue him in such a miraculous way on Mount Carmel, why then run away and hiding under a bush in the desert? Is God then not mighty anymore to save him as well from a messenger with a death warrant? That you're going to kill him? That's very strange. So, it happens. And now what people have discovered, if you stay too long in the minus, that can happen, then you will finally end up in a kind of depression. And how longer you are in the minus field, it's literally a minefield, then how more difficult it is to get out. And now it's interesting that psychologists found that before you cross the zero line, you have to find your escape button. It's on your desk of your computer. Find the escape button. We all have an escape button. And for everybody, it is different. So it doesn't mean you will be demotivated because it started here. But before you really go under into a complete field of negative energy, you can get out. You have to find it. And so maybe you have to turn, when you believe you have a call of God, and you become so demotivated because especially your brothers and sisters are picking on you, saying, you don't have a call, you know, you're not anointed, or things like that. Go to your original call. What did God really tell you? Or if people say, wow, you're not so gifted. Well, when you did a good study, what did your teachers and lectors say? Yeah. Do you have a gift? Stand on that. Wherever you go, and it doesn't matter you are in the Christian arena or in the real arena outside the Christian world, you always face the same problem. There are always people out there who do not like you. There will always be people who will not agree with you. There are always people like that. And to be honest, if I would always have listened to people who told me, now, Lane, you're hopeless. You're helpless. Why shall we stand with you? You think you are a pioneer. You know, all those stories. If we would listen to that, we would have never been here. And countless other projects Rhea and I have been able to do in our life would have never happened. I don't listen to all those voices. I learn to listen to true professionals. That's something else. And I'm totally open for professional critique, but it must be professional critique of recognized people who are true, great people in my field of work. If not, I don't mind. Sometimes it will happen in your church. Some will go to a church. And we all know, not always, your brothers and sisters will understand what you do. Especially when you go to the experimental side of art. Then always there is such a very nice Sister Johnson. And Sister Johnson will come here, just you've done something great, saying, I do not understand, but I will pray for you. You know? How would you feel? Or, I know some stories of our artist here that the pastor found out, and then the pastor is saying, I wish you do that. You did that in my church. Well, not every church is open for very creative things, to be honest. So you have to learn to put those voices aside. So find an escape button. What can it be? For some, it is a prayer. That you just stop the cycle. Just stop the cycle. Silence. Break out. Pray. That can help. For some others, it is stop, silence, put on some very good music that will lift you up. Because you have stopped the cycle before you really go into the negative. For some others, is go out, buy a great meal. That's very Christian. Buy a great meal. For others, have sex with your wife. Hopefully I don't mind, you know, that I can mention all those very normal things. But you have to find a way. Yeah. For some people who you can take as well wrong turns. Drugs can give you the change. Ecstasy pill. There's a growing number of Christian youth using ecstasy pills. When you're more professional, cocaine. Believe me, it's equal there in the Christian world as it is out there. And be very careful with that stuff. because it really can harm you. Those are as well escape buttons, but not good escapes. Yeah. For some, it might be a talk with a good friend, that you talk and open up yourself, say, I'm feeling so rotten. I'm Dutch, so I speak out the words as they are. And you feel that way. An honest talk can help. So it is time for you to think about this mechanism. Because who you are, me included, this is always the same cycle. But I want to get out before I get into here. I stop at here and hold the fort, and then slowly finding new energy again. And for some of you, you have to think about what are sources of motivation. And there are some short-term ones and long-term ones that say a positive motivator is faith. And it gives you positive energy, faith, through faith in what you do, faith in God, faith in the arts, faith in your community, faith in your family is a positive force. So sometimes you have to stop and think, what is my faith? That is what is what I believe in. Family can be incredible source of positive motivation. I stand with my family. I do it for my family. Money is a motivator. Can be positive, can be negative. Depends why. I believe when you are an artist, you should be fairly paid, unless you go to Christian Artists, because, as you all know, you give it here for free. Thank you. But outside of CA, I believe an artist should be paid in a fair way for their professional contributions. So that's positive part. When you get very famous and quite a money stream can come in, the money can become a very negative motivator, because finally you only do it for the money. So think about it. You must have seen that when you have a big number of people, let's say in your hall, with your concert, exhibition, or play, it gives you a feeling of power, because they are there because of your form of art. It can be positive, but it can become in some time very negative, because you get addicted to that feeling of power. Another interesting trick is pride and arrogance. And the difference between being proud on what you do, that is fair, you can be proud on what you do, but to allow pride in your heart. Because, look at me, I'm great. Well, think about it, you know. Arrogance will never help you. It is a power factor for the short term, but on the long run, long term, it may even destroy people. Some things you do for the neighborhood can be very positive. Community service, as an example. Some people are motivated by the laws. The law tells me I have to do this. Well, we are in the Netherlands and we have a law on speed limit, but that's flexible. If you've been on our highways, you've seen it, you know. Who's passing by? Always a Dutchman. Yeah. Sometimes, there can happen something very tragic in your life. And you can develop so much negative energy, it becomes hate. And hate is an incredible power. but very negative, and finally only heading for destruction. So that is in this area. It's negative energy. Hate is very much to the ultra minus. But whoa, stay away from hate. Let always love fulfill your hearts. So there is a whole list known on motivators, and I believe we are here these days to think about what is motivating me. What are my motivators? What will help me in my career, in my life, in public life, in the real world? That is what I wanted to share with you. Tomorrow in the plenum, we will do an interview with Adrian Snell about his motivation, because his life has a very interesting curve and there's lots to learn about that. So now the final chapter for us here together is community of practice. Let me see, hope everybody is here. I call here, we are going to be divided up in small working groups. And when you got your group together, I will later tell you how it works. You go outside. You can go there into, well, all those areas, even in the dining room there, or even outside the building. So, let me see. Heike Wetzel, can you come here? Heike. She is the chief of the instrumentalist. Where are you? Come here on stage. Of the shield. Yeah, instrumentalist. We have singers and vocalists. Didi. So that's the chief of singers and vocals. Then we have singer-songwriters. That's Klaus-André Eickhoff. Where are you? Later on, follow the man with the signs. 2D, Peter Smith. Where are you? Follow the man with the sign. 2D. We have 3D, that is Marijke Bolt. We have photography film. That is Paul Yates. Dance, Damaris. Where is Damaris? Ja, Damaris. Acting, Sjoutje. Sjoutje. We've arts and therapy. That is Yoshiko. So, those are the chiefs of the section. So, we split up and follow the one where you belong. Yeah, you get it? Don't stay here, because you have to do sound and light check and TV check all here. So, follow your group and they will take you somewhere outside. If they hold it up, that they all can see it. Like all those tourists with umbrella, that's your umbrella. Okay, thank you. Class dismissed. See you tonight.